the other step of what we can discuss here, which is related to the employment status and state status when you're able to do the executive orders. So those are questions I've been dealing with a lot. But traditionally, the kind of questions where I usually get, I think most people talking about getting the federal kind of help here. What do I do in this situation?
Let me ask you, because I think this is a deeper level. And almost every attorney you talk about, so this is an important area that's very common to that. But can I tell you what helping people
do that? It's a difficult practice area. We just have to ask these people whether earlier in the process of the statute, of course, is the fee system provision, meaning you can miss the correct rate for your attorney's fees if the state filed with the applicant's fee. The same thing applies when you see a fee that says, being a baby switch on you, or selling the fee for over the sticker price, or failing to pay off a tribute. These are different things that are often in place when it comes to the interaction of fee receipts. And you would take that case under the Illinois Consumer Fraud Act, which allows you to ask for recovery of attorney's fees and litigation costs, because as a legal consumer, you would never have the ability to finance your business.
That's an important point, because people say, well, I need to get the opportunity, but there's nothing to do about it, because that's the case that you have to learn it. You have anything that I need to cover, it's
time. That's not true. That's true in this situation, because if you've been dismissed, you ask for a measurable damages of $10,000 for most of these individuals that do. If you were finding this in the litigation, I'd have to pay your attorney off, but I'd have to take that from A to Z. You need that $10,000 in just a few months. And that is a cost-benefit question. Why not pay more rent than you pay $30,000 to get $10,000 back? No, that's not true, because you can continuously pay your attorney's fees, which means that the attorney will take the case to contingency fee basis of source. Usually the way we structure this is when the state department has something written, so we have to take access funds to cover if it's payment on attorney's fees and maybe some preliminary litigation costs. And then, this is a fee for dealership. It's, in most instances, it's historically the reluctance to admit any renderings, and then you would do it like crazy. I know it's got these different things on the story about those, but those are the two questions I hear on a regular basis. So there's a lot of stuff to do, but I feel like I get those questions as well.
That's interesting, because I think so many people don't handle those kind of cases. And if you put a lot of people trying to do the cost, the cost benefit analysis, then it's going to be the cost.
Right.
Because this is, you think you're going to pay the cost benefit analysis, and it's going to be when you talk about it, not that you're trying to build this case, but it's still an experience, but it's expensive because you're going to stop doing some of that activity from helping everybody else.
And that's the objective, and that's what the consumer product is an asset for. So, I love that business is accountable for doing this to consumers.
So, what else do you, any other kind of analogy, something like that you like to
do? So, I think real estate transactions and real estate litigation too. We mentioned foreclosure defense. I think foreclosure defense that's kind of not as of an issue as it has been in the past 10 years.
And you do that.
Because the business is getting the adverse action notice to the borrower that they want and get